Another order in. The OBS engine. Trying to get away from pre-made coils. I really am. Tried the limitless. Drip tips. Drippers. The aromarizer. Thermarizer. Didn't like any of them. Then I started hearing about the OBS engine. See it? It's top airflow. These are all kind of stiff and tight because that's right out of the box. I haven't juiced or done anything. I haven't even cleaned it yet. Lots of airflow though. I mean, you might as well just breathe. Of course, I don't have any cotton, no coils, no nothing in here. Just a velocity style deck, two Allen keys on each side, or Allen scrub screws on each side. From the other reviewers, like, they were saying they're 2.5 millimeter holes. I don't think so. I'm gonna guess about 1.5. well, I guess they could be two. This unscrews as well. And this is all one piece. The drip tip comes off. Little nubs you've all seen on the other reviews. You line them up in here. That way the airflow hits your coils. Glass separates. Kinda, sorta. There it goes. It's got two O-rings on it, I'll have to keep track of. And then your metal cage on the inside. It does come with the extra glass. It comes with four extra grub screws in case you lose all four. It comes with extra O-rings to replace all of them once. I think I'll stop there. I'm actually going to go rinse this all out and stuff before I actually use it. Doesn't feel like there's any machine oil. Actually feels pretty clean. I'd rather be safe than sorry. So yeah, I'm gonna go rinse everything out. I did get two of them. The other one's also the exact same one. It's in black. I found that when I like something, I like to have a spare. This will go on the shelf and won't be used unless something really goes bad with this. Rulo RS200. Already had this one open. It's just the regular RS200. Don't like the green inside. RX200, not the S. Has the black inside. You can see it. I really need to get a new set of batteries. Absolutely nothing wrong with it. You can see where I had the wrap put on it. Everywhere there's not a wrap, paint's just getting wore off. No issues. I've got the UL SE1, or what I like to call the Crown 3 functional. Very fond of these. If this is even close to this, I got hooked on the Crown's. Crown 1, Crown 2 once they fix their coils, and then the SE, very much hooked on those. Alright, I'm going to go rinse this all up, and we'll throw some coils in it. Oh yeah, I think it came with, let's go over that real quick. I wasn't going to go into it. We've all seen coils that come in these little kits. There's also tons of other videos on. I'm not going to do 100% everything. Cotton, they say it's Japanese organic. I don't know. I got mine that I'll be using. There's the extra O-rings I was telling you. Four extra little set screws. Looks like two stainless twisted coil. Looks like 7-wrap. I was going to use my own twisted coil, but mine's Canthal. You can tell it's a little bit gray over color. Stainless is definitely a lot shinier. Yeah, we'll use those that they sent with it. See what they ohm out at. 7 wraps, dual. I'm guessing probably 0.35-ish. Something like that. All right, so I'm not going to use their cotton. Actually, I have my own cotton that I'll be using. Mine's the organic. Well, it's got a few of those little black spots like theirs did, but mine's much cleaner. I don't know if it really makes a difference, just personal preference. I'll grab these two coils. I think I'll rinse them off too, just because I don't know who did what and where and when. Of course, everything's going to come out except what I want. There they go. And again, these are just the ones that came with it. Let's set them all down so I don't lose these little grub screws. It does come with an extra glass, as you can see sitting up here. Comes with the Allen screwdriver. All the usual suspects you'd expect to have from anyone decently making and sending you a mod. Tank, atomizer, cartomizer, drip tank. Hopefully they all come with that kind of stuff. Now when I got my SE from UL, came with O-rings, but did not come with an extra glass. A lot of people, that's a big con. I guess it is kind of with me too. I mean, if something happens, I've had a lot of tanks. I've never broke one yet. Should never have said that. Now I'm going to break it. I did, however, put this little rubbery thing on here, which is now stuck. Not to protect the glass, which is what it's meant for, because I can actually hold it, squeeze the glass, and unscrew. That's what I use it for. But it protects the glass too. Alright, so I'm going to go rinse this, and I'll be back. Alright, so I got it all cleaned out, dried off. Time to put some coils in it. I know my camera doesn't do the whole super nice up and closey, but you've all seen, you're familiar with just slapping some coils in. Not doing anything spectacular. Do the top one on that side. Bottom one on this side. And just loosen it enough to get the coils in. Eventually get the coils in. There we go. Actually need now. I'm going to kind of tighten them, but not fully tighten. Just enough to hold everything. Never used this tank before, or this mod. Most velocity style stacks are, you know, pretty much the same. Last thing you want to do is get it cut and done and look at it, and you're too short because you're touching the stack or anything. Gotta pull and even them out over those holes. Make sure it's not touching. There's one. Pretty happy with it. I'm going to go ahead and just tighten these down. Wasn't a whole lot more to go. And these were flat, so hopefully they don't break the wire. I turned that pretty tight, dented it, didn't break. Cutters are here somewhere. One done. Loosen up the top on this one. And then the bottom one. Slide the second coil in. Pretty good right there. So again, I'm going to snug it down. Not overly tight, just enough to hold it. Do some ranging, get it where I want it. Make sure it's not touching or shorting out. Good clearance underneath on both. Might tweak that one a little bit, this one down a little bit. It's a little better. Go ahead and tighten them up. Double checking the other side as well. Now I do have a Coilmaster 521 tab on its way. Actually ordered it before this. Still not here yet. It's supposed to be here tomorrow. But these are the ones that came with it. Kind of expect them to be around between 3 and 4.5. I'm guessing probably closer to 3. I am actually going to use my Rulo RS2. Dry fire and check the ohms. Set of new batteries for this one. Never want to swap them around, even though they're basically the same device. A little tighter since it's new. And turn it down to about 20 watts. Whoop, bounce you around the room. Down to about 20 watts. Yeah, I did that software update on it. I gotta hide that. It pops up every now and then, says WizMec. You can change that as well. It's a JPEG file. I'm gonna end up putting my own name in there. And, oh, came out lower than I thought. 0.14. Grab my ceramic tweezers. Now you can turn this display off. I think it's bottom right and hold the power button. Not too worried about it though. Pull some up. Resistance will change a little bit once they get warmed up, too. Might have to go up a little. A bit of 30 watts. Well, now they're starting to get warm up. Top one's doing really good. You can see that bluing you get from stainless steel. Yeah, it's starting to warm up. There we go. Not evenly though. The front one's a lot slower. Now they're getting there. Yeah, they're heating up pretty close. Inside out. And actually, still says 1.4. Now I'm going to turn it off. Looks like I need to change my batteries. I thought I'd charge them. Normally I take just the one out, but since these need charged, I'm going to take them both out. Or both. All three. Let that cool off a little bit. Put our cotton in. Nothing worse than burnt cotton. Those look like 3 mil. And I know a lot of the reviewers have different opinions on where to end the cotton. Most of them say just inside those four holes. Mike Vapes being one of them. Then you got DGLS Vapes who says put it all the way through the holes, all the way to it touches the bottom. Instructions say put it all the way through until it touches the bottom. I'm conflicted. So I very much agree with pretty much everything Mike says. Mike Vapes, that is. So I think it's always easier to cut it later if we need to. So I'm going to go ahead and go all the way to the deck. Follow the instructions in the instruction book. See what happens. If I don't like it, I can always pull them out and shorten them up if we need. Alright, cooled off. I'm actually going to kind of trim that down a little bit though. Let's see if we can stuff that in that hole. And again, I'm going to make sure it's just touching the bottom of the deck in there. Make sure it's not stuff. Plenty of room in between there, not too tight. Trim the other side. Since that went in so easy, I'm not going to shave this one down. Put it in and see what happens. I can always pull it and trim it if we need to. Just touching the bottom of the deck. Got the little fuzzies. Then we gotta do the other side. And I don't have any exact science when I do this. 3 millimeter hole diameter. Kind of guesstimate 3 millimeter width on these. It seems to be working. And I peel the outer and inner layers, those hard ones. Just because those don't soak up as easily, they're a little bit more dense. I'm trying to get it to point out. Like I said, I trimmed the other one, but it looked like I didn't need to, so I'm not going to do it this time. I know you always see the other ones, they trim both ends and have everything perfect. I'm far from perfect. Get it in, just touching the bottom. Plenty of room for juice. Then I'll cut the other end. Komodo dragon cotton. It's actually pretty good stuff. Doesn't have that odd cottony taste, you know, you have to burn through a half a tank to get rid of it. Tastes fine first puff, as I spit all over myself. Spread it out on the bottom. Make sure the air flows aren't covered. Some juice, and in this case I'm using Pound It by Food Fighters. Just get them started to wicking. I'm gonna grab a paper towel and I'll be right back. Got my little bit of spillage there. I'll put just a bit more on here though. Didn't think to grab the other batteries. I just want to make sure that my first experience of this is not a dry hit. Really, really wanting to light this tank. RTA. Alright, so we gotta put all our stuff back together. Cleaned it all out, pretty much dry. As far as I can tell, it doesn't matter which way the glass goes. Same on both ends. Except here, we got the inner and the outer. Or top and bottom, I guess. So we screw this on. Get that all tight. Where's the drip hole? So I'm going to line that up. A little mark on here, it shows you where the drip hole is. So when you slide this up, it's right there. Still a little bit of water in there. I thought I got that all. It's not much, just a little drop, but... And then we line those holes up, which are pretty much just like this. I know you really can't see that, but you see how the inside part is not turning. So you know it's locked in. I don't want to crank it into my mod and scratch anything up, so I'm going to take it off, do it by hand. Make everything's good and tight. Now on these, and if you look at it with the gasket and the O-ring down here, there is absolutely zero capabilities of it leaking out the bottom. only way it can leak is out the air holes at the top or the mouthpiece itself. There's nowhere for it to leak down here. And like I said, you might as well just breathe. There's no restriction. So, find our hole. There it is. I know I'm doing everything right opposite of what would work, but I'm right-handed. I'm just going to fill it up. Nice big hole. I mean, you could put a dripper bottle in there. Holds 5.2 milliliters. Kind of tipping it up. I'm not going to measure it. Plenty of the other reviewers, Mike and DGLS Vapes and the rest of them, they all, you know, use their measuring syringes, and they, you know, it's 5.2. Close enough, if not. Actually, I think both of them got actually probably closer to 5.5. And we slide that down. Well, it's kind of seeping in. I want to make sure I don't get a dry hit. I'm going to pick up my little bit of tools here. And that's actually it for that. Put my cap on here. I'm sure I'll edit all this out so you don't have to see me put everything away. Who knows? It's a pretty short video. I might just leave it in there. .14 ohms though, I'm not all that happy with. I'm definitely going to get some new coils. I'll probably make my own. Those are 7 wrap. I'll probably go 9 or 10. I'd like to get them up to at least 3 ohms. Gotta grab some batteries. These batteries are not brand new. They're the only ones I got that are charged. So that's the ones that are in here. Oh, those are pretty much full. But one thing I noticed on the RS200 that I did not realize with the RS200 is it actually shows your amps as well. I mean, you got your volts, your ohm, your amps. If that display would go away, shows your wattage. Yeah, we definitely need to get rid of that one. I think it's down and hold up logo. We're gonna turn it off. Oh. I went into preheat power mode. Did not want that. Turn the logo from on to off, because that's just really honestly getting annoying. Now it's gone. See, the ohms came up to 0.16 from 0.14, only at about 30 watts. And pretty much nothing, as you'd expect with 0.16. Let's go ahead and go up to 50. We'll go 51 watts. It's coming in at 2.86 volts, 0.16 ohms. Again, fresh cotton, fresh build. Still pretty weak, but that tasted odd. Yeah, let's go ahead and take this up to 60. Huge flavor, huge airflow. I actually turned it down to almost where it looks like a circle. actually pretty good. A little bit more air. You can see. What you do on one is the same on all three. There's three of them. I'd say with that much of an opening, it's about the same as these openings on the UL SE1. That's at 60 watts. I guess this one's at 55. I think I'm going to take it up just a little bit more. Let's try 65. Had just a couple little spit back. Brand new coil, brand new tank, brand new cotton. Definitely have to burn them in a little bit. Now typically I would say with my cotton you don't have to go like a half a tank to get a good flavor. But these are definitely got airflow. I think if I changed out those coils and put 0.4, 0.5 in, I'd be much happier. Definitely gets a little warm, the tip. But I usually don't vape. 60 is usually the highest I ever go. But again, that's on pre-made coils. At 0.5 ohms, I don't know if you can read that, and they're at 5.25 volt. So draw longer, put out about the same or a little less as what this does at 65 watts for just a few seconds. Oh yeah, definitely more clouds. Let me give it just a little bit more air though. Let's see if I can cool it off. Tank is ice cold. I mean, it's not even warm. The tip gets a little warm. So open up the airflow, just, I'd say 3/4, roughly. All the way open. As you can see, they're all the way open, all the way around, still at 65 watts. And obviously no drippage, because there's nowhere for it to drip. A little bit of a gap. I didn't have it screwed down quite tight. Now there's no gap. Definitely a lot shorter. This one holds 5 mil. This holds 5.2. Seems a little odd to say on an RTA. It feels dry. Kind of like a ceramic tank. Kind of that dry hit. Not like a dry hit, like it's running out of juice, but the vapor itself is dry. I was also going to check, this is the 25 millimeter tank. It just comes to the edge on the RX200S. I mean, it doesn't overhang, If we can see that, I mean, it's right there. I don't know if I should go up or not. Let's try 70. We're at 70 watts. Still at 0.16 ohms, 3.35 volts. See what appears to be air bubbles in there. Not getting a dry hit, you know, like no juice or anything, definitely not. This kind of tastes like a ceramic tank, like the CeraVapes, their ceramic tank, the Cerebus. Kind of has that taste to it, or, is texture the right word? Kind of a ceramic-y dry hit, but not dry like I ran out of juice. Definitely lots of bubbles in there. So it's wicking. I had a couple little spitbacks there at first. Oh yeah, now there's juice on that. That thing slides a lot easier. There you go, this way. Yeah, slides a lot easier. A little oozing as you would expect. Wipe that off. Now the flavor's starting to kick in a little bit. And yes, I'm kind of chain vaping it. I'm only running, what is that, six milligrams? Tips didn't, definitely getting warm. Tank is not. I think it's just warm for my hands. Well, there might be just a hair more cloud. I'm also drawing a lot more on this. No, I think this is putting out more. I'm just drawing longer on this because it's a lower wattage. It's not getting as warm on the tip. Got some crusties. Definitely don't like that high wattage. Let's go back down to 60. I think actually it's doing pretty damn good for what it is. The coils I'm going to change out. I don't like that low of an ohm. I think we might have a winner. There's a reason I definitely watch all the other reviewers out there, you know, Mike Vapes, Vape and Fagan, DGLS Vapes, of course. Those are the three biggest, definitely Sophie Vapes as well. She doesn't quite get into as much of the technical side like DGLS Vape does. I don't think anyone gets as technical as he does. I think for an overall, just what it is, what it looks like, how to use it, Mike Vapes and Vape Fagan are probably the two of my favorites. And then Sophie, if I just want to, you know, one more opinion before I actually go buy something. And then DGLS vapes, if I really want, you know, tear it down, take it apart. This is what it is. Here's a spreadsheet on it, you know, 40-minute video. Gotta love him for that, though. Yeah. I think with some different coils, I'd be much, much happier, but this could definitely be an all-day vape. But to be 100% honest, now granted, new coils, new tank, new cotton, pre-built. This has just an edge on flavor. I would have to say, after all the RTAs I've had, this is my favorite right now. Thank you.